Today, here at Satori Graphics, you're going to learn how to make a professional business card in Illustrator, perfectly print ready as a PDF file. To skip the intro, move to the timestamp in the corner. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I would like to remind all of my subscribers to turn on the notifications by clicking the bell icon. You're never going to miss an upload if you do this. But let's jump right into this tutorial on how to make a professional business card in Illustrator. We need to make a new document in Illustrator for our business card. I'm working in CC 2017 in case this menu looks a bit weird to you. As this is going to be a print-ready business card, we want to select print. I use millimeters, and in the description below I've added a link to various sizes of business card around the world, but the standard size that I use is 85mm in width by 55mm in height. We're going to need two artboards, and it's crucial that you use cmyk as the color mode. And then a 3mm bleed that, if you click this icon here, is going to be around the entire canvas. I'll explain what a bleed is soon. Here you have more settings in case you want to take a look. The space between the canvas and the red line is the bleed. This is essential for printers to make sure there are no print anomalies and everything is flush. You need to bring your design to the red line, but everything in the bleed will be cut away and discarded. Take the polygon tool and then click the artboard. You need to type in three sides to generate a triangle. This will be the makeshift logo design for my professional business card in today's Illustrator tutorial. Adjust the stroke to something similar to mine here, and then take the scissors tool to cut two points into the triangle in the bottom right. You can then remove this section with the selection tool by pressing delete on the keyboard. We now need to outline the stroke and then bring down a guide. If you don't have your rulers open, press Ctrl or Command R on your keyboard. This is where we take the direct selection tool to change the shape of the design. If you notice here, when I drag the anchor down, it says on. This is basically Illustrator telling you that the anchor is on the same line as it was previously, which is what we want for our design. Go ahead and adjust the shape similar to mine. Hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag the shape to duplicate it like so. Rotate the new shape by 180 degrees and then place it next to the other one. If you select both shapes and then press Command or Control G, it's going to group them together. Go ahead and duplicate this group over and over across the business card canvas. Once you have your row of shapes, align them in the Align window, like I've done here. Group this entire section together, and then duplicate them below. This will be half of the front side of the business card, so resize it by making it half of the canvas, and then duplicate that down one more time. You can make sure everything's equally spaced apart by using this option in the Align window. Using a white fill and then the rectangle tool, make a shape over the entire canvas up until the bleed, and then send it to the back. You can then lock this down so it doesn't move around throughout this business card tutorial. Next, go ahead and open the Pathfinder window. You will need to select the shapes and then ungroup them twice. Draw a shape down one side that will cut away the excess shapes. Press Command or Control C to copy the shape, and then hold down Shift to select the rectangle shape and one of the logos. Using the minus front option in the Pathfinder window, you will now delete this part. Press Command or Control F to paste it back into place, and repeat the process on this side and on the right hand side of the business card. To finish off the front of our professional business card, make sure everything is ungrouped, and then duplicate one of the logo shapes. Make a circle with the ellipse tool by holding down Shift. I personally feel that gold and black and white is a great colour scheme for this business card, so make a circle and then make it gold. Add a white fill to the logo and bring it to the front of all the layers, and then place it on the design. We will now work on the back side of the business card, so add a white shape that goes all the way up to the bleeds and then lock it in place. I forgot to send this shape to the back when I was making my design, but it doesn't really matter too much. Duplicate a logo from the shapes on the left hand side and then bring it over to the artboard. You would also want to make a circle and make sure the logo is on the above layer. I went for a white logo on a black circle, which I think works well, but feel free to experiment for your professional business card design. For the social media icons, I saved an image from the internet and then I opened it in Illustrator. Go ahead and open the image trace window with the icon selected. Click the Ignore White option and make sure Black and White are selected. Click Preview to see how the final outcome is going to look, and then when you're happy, go up to Object, Image Trace, and Expand. You now have a vector icon for your business cards. And you can do this for all icons. You can also open up the symbol window and then locate the web icons. Here, you're going to find internet icons such as email, phone, and internet in case you want to use them yourself. Here I've used a guide to make sure everything is aligned perfectly, and all of my text on my business card is a version of Helvetica in case you want to know. To finish off the business card in Illustrator, you can group together the right section here, and then group together the left section on the back, and then you can align them like so. At this juncture, save your business card as an Illustrator file, and then outline all of your type ready for a PDF. Go ahead and save your design as Illustrator PDF, and choose the newest version of Acrobat, and click the View PDF after saving option. I'm going to use these pre-mark settings here. And if you have any warnings on your print job, they will be displayed here. Once you've saved it, you can check over your design for any errors or anomalies. So there was a Satori Graphics tutorial on how to make a professional business card in Illustrator, perfectly print ready. If you enjoyed this tutorial or found it useful, drop a comment and a like on the video, and share my content so somebody else can see it. Subscribe for weekly graphic design uploads, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.